DJ CK, hein? Produzindo mais uma no mundo de Nárnia. Ó, é o bicho, hein? Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, na, na. Oh,
na,
na.
So that was the foot shake challenge, which if you don't know what it is, then you will do pretty soon, I'm sure of it. It was featured in a test last week, and I'll leave a link in the description for you to check it out. Now, with trends and fads, you can do one of three things. You can ignore it and it'll continue as normal. You can tell the kids to stop doing it and they'll want to do it more. Or the third option, which is the best one in my opinion, is you can embrace it and use it as a lesson. Now, with dance, you have to follow a set or sequence of instructions or moves, and it's a great way to teach algorithms. So, first of all, we sat in the hall, and we watched the dance that I recorded at home over the weekend, and then we looked at the key moves and revised our lefts and rights, which is key if you want to nail this dance. And then, finally, we got into groups of threes, got some pens and paper, and we tried to create an algorithm that would help us learn the dance. The kids loved it because they were active. But they're also learning about algorithms and coding in a really fun and different way, and I think it worked perfectly well. It was ace to see just the conversations and hear the communication and the language going in the class. It was great. And even at lunchtime, I looked out my window, which is just there, and some of them were actually practicing the dance at lunchtime and trying to write an algorithm, which was wonderful. Later in the day, we then combined coding and dancing again using Studio Code, which honestly, I cannot recommend it enough. Check it out. I'll leave a link in the description as well. It's wonderful. This is kind of what it looks like. So there you have it now. I'm off to hone my dancing skills with my dog, Alan.
Producing mais uma no mundo de Nárnia.